Hello and happy weekend. It's a very blustery, windy AF day outside. It's actually so dark and so like rainy that the only space that I could find with kind of nice lighting was in my window in my dressing room. So that's where I am. I don't think I've ever filmed a video here before. I'm in my little pink velvet chair, chilling, cozy, and I thought to start this vlog off today, A, got a new camera, went out this morning, purchased the new Canon G7X Mark II. The other one lasted many a year, but it has gone to camera heaven. Two, just want to apologise for the greasy hair. I was gonna wash my hair this morning. I can't say I enjoy washing my hair, but I love when my hair is washed. And I looked, took one look outside, realised that it was peeing it down and so windy, and I was like, there is no point. I'm literally gonna stay in, chill out. Me and Alfie have literally been on the sofa eating food with the fire on, watching films and just chilling, and I was like, oh, I can't be bothered. So you'll just have to excuse the somewhat greasy hair, but you know, such is 2020. I feel like I have probably had more grease in my hair, more greasy hair days than freshly washed days in 2020, I'm not gonna lie. I thought I would start the vlog today. What the hell was that? Something just crunched and I don't know what it was. I thought I would start today's vlog by doing a little Q&A. So I actually asked on Instagram if you had any questions. I feel like I haven't done this in a really long time. And actually one of the most asked questions was, how are you? Which is so lovely of you to ask. And it really made me think, like, how am I generally? Obviously I have my health, I have my happiness, I have, you know, nothing to complain about. Very, very lucky in that sense. But obviously my mental health has been something to get used to, deal with, live with. Is a part of my life. You have your good days, you have your bad days, you have your up days, you have your down days. And I would say generally, been pretty good. Recently, I feel, and I go through these phases all the time, more so late 20s, early 30s, I guess I'm early 30s now. I didn't ever really experience this in my early 20s. I mean, I've been making videos for, I was gonna say 19 years, since I was 19, for 11 years. As I've gotten older, I have found it harder to be really like raw and vulnerable and open and like honest with my feelings in my vlogs. And I feel like that was something that I used to do a lot. I used to probably overshare in some capacity through the years, especially with things I would show or things I would film or like conversations I would have. In the grand scheme of things, or to some people, maybe not, but I think looking back, I feel, and maybe that's just because of the state of mind I'm in right now, I'm like, oh my god, why are you filming that? Like, why are you showing that? Why are you talking about that? And it's a really weird feeling. I don't know if I can explain it, but it's probably one of the reasons why I don't really sit down like this and just have like open convos and Q&As and things, because I feel a little bit like, do people really care? Like, don't talk about that thing that bothered you, or don't talk about your down day here. No one cares. And I think also over the years, I've grown a very thick skin with a lot of things. And I am really good in my personal life with talking about how I feel and talking about things that are bothering me, or something that I've seen, or something that's going on that's like affecting me. I'm really good at that, but I never bring it here. And I think I once used to do that. This is probably making no sense, but I'm just trying to start off with a very honest how I am, because in a couple of vlogs back, actually it was in August, I said if someone asks you how you are, you should take the time to be honest and give an honest answer, which is what I'm trying to do, even though I find this so hard. And one of the things that I feel like I should address is the fact that I find it so hard, because yeah, it's weird. It's really, really weird, because I know I have like the loveliest community of people, but sometimes I just feel like I don't want to waste anyone's time. No, I think I'm just having like a confidence crisis. Who knows? Anyway, I just thought I'm going to bite the bullet and I'm going to sit and do a Q&A and just open up, because clearly that's where I'm feeling not very confident. To answer your question, how are you? I'm actually fine. It's just that one thing. But it also means that I feel like I don't want to be online as much, and I find myself like distancing myself a bit more, because I'm like, why are you sharing that? Why are you posting that? No one cares. Like, I don't know. I think I'm overthinking it massively. Since you love autumn a lot, what do you hate the most during this season? Rain. I also really struggle with seasonal affective disorder at this time of year. And I feel like I've said this before, when that initial dark evening set in, I am so tired by 6 p.m. and it really throws me off. And every year the same thing happens and I think, I must be ill. What is wrong with me? Why is it getting to 6 and I feel like this? Like, forcing myself to stay awake, don't really have any appetite in the evening because I feel like I just need to go to bed. And it's when the weather changes. So that, like, I love autumn, but that's when I feel the most sluggish in the evenings. I think once my body gets used to the darker evenings, I'm fine. But yeah, no, I would say that, I think. And the rain, because I love a crisp autumn day when the sun is out and it's like a bit chilly. And you can like wrap up and you can still go out and do nice things and the lighting is really lovely and like sunny. But the minute it starts raining, what can you do? Do you have friends that hate being online in your vlogs? Have I never answered this? In the 11 years, I don't think I have. I have friends who would prefer not to be. It's just not their thing. And I have friends who don't mind it, but they wouldn't be like, oh, hey, let's film a vlog. But if I started filming, they're just like, oh, it's just what she does. I have friends that I would feel more comfortable filming around. I have friends that do the same thing, so they like are in videos. And I have friends who wouldn't be in videos. So I would say nobody hates it, but not everybody is like well up for it, if you know what I mean. Like, it is kind of intimidating if it's not the realm you're in. How do you feel about YouTube? Do you think it's changed in the last few years? I think all social media platforms have changed and will continue to change as the years go on. I think it was probably quite naive of me at 19 to think that YouTube would stay as it was. Over the years, obviously, there are so many more users of social media. There are so many more accounts created on the platforms that it's always gonna change and grow and adapt, and I 100% think it's changed. I think when I first started on YouTube, it was a place for sharing your passions, your creativity, creating communities, getting feedback from people. It felt cozy. That's the only word I can think of. It felt cozy and it felt safe and it felt like... So this is how I explained it to somebody the other day, and I don't mean this to sound really dramatic. I said something along the lines of, the internet was where you would go to escape real life. It was like this cozy place that you could go and you could make friends and you could be creative, and it felt like an escape from the real world. And now I feel like more people are escaping the internet and social media to be in the real world, to escape social media. And it was actually around Digital Detox Day that I was talking about that, and I think I can only speak for myself. Having been in this space for so long, I can see how it's changed. And some of those things are for the better. Like, thinking of the amount of people that have sought comfort, friendship, you can still create those communities online. Those communities do still exist online. I just think that's not Now that's not the sole purpose for it, which I think is the main difference. I don't know. As I said around Digital Detox Day, there are some incredible positives, but there are also some incredible negatives too. And as the platforms grow, those positives will grow and those negatives will grow, and it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger, doesn't it? And that's kind of terrifying, but also amazing. So it's such a double-edged sword. Personally, I preferred social media platforms when it felt like a cozy, friendly environment. And I know those environments do still exist, and I'm lucky that I have those environments with you guys. And I have some people watching these videos who have been here since I was 19. Oh my god, let me know if you're one of those people, because bloody hell, I feel like I need to send you a medal or something. But yeah, I don't know. Again, let me know what you think. How do you feel like it's changed? Were you here for the cozy days? That's the only way I can describe it. Maybe it wasn't that cozy for you. Maybe you actually prefer it now. I don't know. Will you ever sell your house? Right now, I could think of nothing worse. I love this house so much. And I get asked quite a lot in like interviews and things, like, is this your forever home? And it's hard to know, I suppose. Right now it feels that way. If I ended up having 7 children, I mean, that's not the plan, but would I want a bit more space if I had like an army of children? Probably. Would I need it? No. I love this house. I love where we are. I love the space. I love what we've done to it. Right now I can't imagine moving from here, but never say never. You don't know if circumstances will ever change, so. But right now, no. Are you interested in doing any TV competitions, e.g. Strictly, Dancing on Ice, I'm a Celebrity? I get asked this all the time, and I do feel like I've answered a couple of these over the years on my Instagram. I've been asked to do a lot of them, but it's just not for me. The one I made the exception for was Great British Bake Off. I was going to say Baking Come Dancing then, because it's my cozy program and I love it so much that I knew I would absolutely kick myself if I didn't do it. To say it was easy for me to do that, I cannot even tell you. I don't think I slept for like 4 weeks before that. It was also for charity, and it was a 2-day thing. You know, it's not like reality TV, kind of like the other things. It's not as intense, you know. Those types of shows scare me. I don't think I could do it. I would absolutely hate to be pulled to pieces, or I don't know, be that exposed, I suppose. I started doing a few little TV bits back in 2014, I think, and more kind of mainstream style things, just to like test it out. I was always being asked to go on radio shows and TV shows and things, and I did This Morning with Phil and Holly, and I did Loose Women. I don't know if I did anything else. I did Bake Off. And after that, I decided I didn't really want to do any more, because I like my online space. I like being, I don't want to say in control, because that makes me sound like a control freak, but I like being here, and those things felt so out of my comfort zone and so terrifying that they just weren't good for me. I would worry myself into an absolute frenzy whenever I had anything like that. So these days I don't. However, if something came up and I felt like I had the confidence to, then maybe I would consider it again. But I just feel like it's not my terrain. When it's live as well, like, the fear that I will get like a mind blank, or that I will say something stupid, is just too much. So I just say no. I'm always just like, oh, I'm really sorry, it's just not for me. If something came up, like Bake Off did, that I was like, I think I can do that, and I think I'd really enjoy that, and I think that that would be a great thing to do, then never say never, but for now, no. I have so many of you asking me if I'm gonna do Strictly or I'm a Celebrity. Oh, I'm sorry if that's disappointed you. If it wasn't on TV, I'd do it. I'd love to learn to dance. The TV stuff and the live stuff really terrifies me. Also, I'm the fussiest eater, which is why I would never do I'm a Celeb, because I feel like everybody would vote me to do the eating challenges and I would absolutely hate my life because I have emetophobia. Have Haskins brought back Mark's anchovy pizza? I don't know, actually. We've not been in a while. Do you think that lockdown slash COVID has strengthened you and Alfie's relationship? I like this one. I feel like we already had a very strong relationship. Obviously, before this year, Alfie and I had been together like 7 years, 8 years now. And our relationship was already very strong. We've definitely weathered a few storms, like most couples, and we have our moments or our bickering arguments, or you know, I think like all couples will go through the motions of different things. Going into lockdown, I did think like, what is this gonna be like? Because we're both so on the go all the time. I do feel like since then, I don't know what it is. I think we communicated better. I think like we were both just dealing with this crazy thing, and like, and there was a really small part of me once lockdown was released and you could start like seeing small groups of people again, there was a really tiny part of me that was like, I'm gonna really miss like this time of just me and Alfie. Obviously very selfishly. Obviously, I'm happy that we're not in a lockdown anymore. But yeah, there was like a tiny part of me that was like, oh, that was like so nice. Just it being us and having all that time together. Is that really smushy? It's quite smushy, isn't it? Very important question. Favorite scene of The Greatest Showman? Oh my gosh. That's so hard. I love Million Dreams. All of that, all those shots. Them dancing like through the street and then on the rooftop. I love that. That's one of my favorite scenes. I also really like the end scene where he hands him the hat and he's like, and he says, where are you going? And he's like, I'm gonna watch my girls grow up. Oh, gets me every time, so cute. Please can you talk more about your emetophobia slash future pregnancy? I have the same fear. Interesting. And I guess the pregnancy thing comes into the hundreds of you asking me when I'm having a baby. It's a really tricky question. I know Alfie touched on this in one of his videos. Growing up, I never even second guessed asking or thinking about when people are going to have babies. But as I've got to a point in my life where I'm starting to think about it more, or friends of mine are getting pregnant and you read more about, you know, the issues you can face with pregnancy or fertility or miscarriage, or and these things are so common, and it really opened my eyes up. And when people started asking me a lot, when are you guys having a baby, hurry up and have a baby, some of you ask really nicely, some of you demand. This is our real life and we're not just gonna have a baby because you really want us to. We of course want to start a family. It's been a dream of both of ours forever, but we want to do it when we want to do it and when the timing feels right. And it's not something that I will openly share until it's happening. And because of all those things, when you get older and you realize like, oh yeah, women can have real issues with this, or I'd never even thought of that, or my friend Maddie is currently pregnant and I have learned so much just from speaking to Maddie about so many different things that I have no idea about. And it does make you realize like it's a question that's best kept to yourself. I've been guilty of it. Years ago, I used to say like, well, when are you gonna have another one, when someone had had one, or like someone would get married and I'd be like, oh, baby next. I would never do that now. Just because you don't know someone's like, you don't know someone's situation. Alfie and I are not trying right now, but if we were, and my whole Q&A was filled with like, when are you having a baby? I don't know how that would make me feel. So we are, and we will. but please don't ask me every time, because there will come a point where that could be a very real situation. And I don't know how good it is to ask women when they're having a baby. Although I understand the excitement, I get it, but be excited internally. I promise we'll tell you when it happens. In terms of the emetophobia, it's such a weird one because, and I've actually talked about this with my therapist before, because it's something I always knew in the back of my mind, like, I'm gonna have to do that one day. I'm gonna have to get pregnant and have a baby, and oh my god, morning sickness in the first trimester is gonna be really awful. But I think when I think that as like a 20-year-old, it feels so far away that I don't worry about it. And now as a 30-year-old, and I'm like, okay, the chances of me having children in the next 10 years are kind of high, that's closer than it was before, it is quite scary. And I do start worrying about it, and I have talked to my therapist about it before. So I can't work out, I think because of my fear, I've not been sick in a really, really, really long time. I'm very good at forcing myself not to be sick. Also, a little bit of a trigger warning, I suppose, if you don't like to even hear anyone talking about this topic, you should probably click off this video at this point or skip ahead. I don't know if anyone else, please let me know if any of you are the same. I know there have been times over the last 12 years where I probably should have thrown up and I didn't. I don't know how, but I managed to stop myself. My overarching panic attacks and anxiety are based off of this. It's sort of weaved its way into lots of different scenarios, but if you strip it all right back, it all comes back to me being sick and the fear of that. I'm a lot better than I used to be. In fact, Nala threw up on our bed like 2 nights ago and I cleared that up. I'm fine with like dog sick. Alfie was to throw up, I'd go and stay in the spare bedroom because I wouldn't want to catch it. If I knew he had eaten something, it would be different. I still wouldn't like it. It would still make my heart race and I would feel really, really anxious and like I was gonna have a panic attack, but I wouldn't worry in the same way. So I think my fear, and I've not explored it in depth. I've not done like hypnotherapy or anything, and I've not done, what's it called when you're like exposure therapy? Oh my God. But it's bad enough that I worry more about the first trimester in pregnancy than I do about actually having the baby.
Right.
Oh, fuck, you scared me.
When's the babysitter coming?
When's the what?
Babysitter coming. Oh shit, you're filming.
But I don't know, it's one of those things, we'll see what happens when it happens, but yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that does scare me a little bit. You what?
Sorry, what?
Stop it! I said that I feel like we're stronger since lockdown, do you think that?
Yeah, I've been working at tons.
You're in a weird mood. I can sense it. Do you like my little setup?
We've got to leave the house in 15 minutes and I haven't eaten dinner. And the one thing you said to me earlier is, you have to have eaten dinner before we leave.
Yes.
And now I realise
you haven't.
I fucked up.
What are you going to do?
This is a cool setup.
Isn't it? It's the only place in the house with like nice lighting.
It's probably the only place in the house we've never filmed before either.
That's what I said.
Other than...
Look, come and sit next to me.
I've literally got no trousers
on. Yeah, but they won't see
enough
that.
Enough to like slide in.
Should we answer one together? What's the one question you wish people would stop asking you? What's the biggest difference between you now and you then, like 2030?
That's a good one.
You can help me answer this.
Grown up.
Yeah, I think...
More mature. Want different things in life. At a different point in life.
Yeah, definitely.
Like...
My priorities are different. My priorities are different.
Massively.
I think I view the world differently.
But equally, when I was... I don't know, 23, maybe like then. Wait, in 2013? Shit, I would have been 20. Okay, when I was 20, I thought I was older.
Same.
I didn't think that my views or anything would change as much as it has done.
The difference for me
between 23 to 27 is ridiculous. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
At 23, I didn't think much more would change. I thought I was just like an adult. And I'm sure still loads more will change, but like the things that
even the things we used to film, like I was saying at the start of this, I'm like, there's certain things that we used to film, and I'm like, I wouldn't film that now, or I wouldn't say that now, or like, I wouldn't upload that as a video now. But I quite like that it's a time capsule. Yeah, it's like,
and I'm glad we did it. I don't regret doing any of the things we'd like filming intensely like we did.
Because
I just don't want that in my life anymore.
Yeah, it's true. Like Alfie used to daily vlog. Like,
for 4.5 years, every day.
So intense. Like, why? But now.
No, I loved it. I know why. I bloody loved it. You liked it as well. But it's only when we're reflecting back. Like, if we look back at those moments, how many unbelievable times we had.
For sure, for sure. But now I'm like, I'm glad we did it, but I would not do it now. That's the difference.
No, it just wouldn't suit our lives. We wouldn't be able to do the work we do now and the projects we're working on whilst vlogging.
Yeah, I think I'm just older. I think I'm older, probably not wiser.
Oh, definitely wiser.
Wiser to some things.
Definitely.
I think I'm stronger. I think I've got a thicker skin in some areas, but not in others. I actually think as I've got older, I've got worse at some things. I can't vlog in public now without feeling awkward, and I used to do that without a problem. And now I'm like, oh God. It's a long amount of time, and you do change. Like, that's 7 years for me, 23, from when I was 23 to now. That's 7 years. That's the whole time you're in secondary school.
And I think the cool thing is that we've changed, obviously, gradually, over time, and we can see the change. Like, we can go back on videos to 2013 and watch those, to 2014, like, to 2015, to 2016, to 2017, to 2018, 2019.
Who's that obnoxious guy and girl, like, running around?
Yeah, like...
This is going to be the longest Q&A ever.
I'm sorry, I'll probably long this out. Do you want me to leave? I need to go get dressed.
I need to leave anyway. We need to go.
I feel like we just haven't really answered the question fully. Maybe we have.
Right, short answer.
2013 to now, the last 7 years, how have you changed? Go.
I think I've matured. I don't know how to answer that. Because I don't know. I'm still like a bit goofy and I still laugh at stuff.
Yeah,
that's not
but
funny,
that's just you. You're always going to be like that.
I think I had... My anxiety's not as bad, I can say that. Nowhere near as bad. Like, I think I've just grown up and I see the world slightly differently and I feel differently about things. Mm. I feel like I've zoomed out of my 20s. I feel like I'm able to like look back into my 20s and be like, why did you do that? Or I would never do that now. Or like, I don't know. It is weird. It is really weird. I feel like my 20s were definitely... was definitely like a portion of my life that was crazy, like so crazy.
Oh, like
I will
madness.
Always look back at my 20s and be like,
holy shit,
well done for like, you know, coming out the other end of that. And in 7 years from now, we'll look back at this video and we'll be like, oh my God. Right, I'm gonna
7 years from now, I'm gonna be tatted up with 9 kids.
9? That's literally physically impossible.
Wow. Who said
it's
just with you?
And oh my God, Alfie. You have to hope they can't see a reflection in my glasses. Can you put that away? Stop!
Is that not sexy?
I have a Bath and Body Works haul to do, which usually I do with Mark, and I'm sad that we're not able to do that because he is in a tier 2 lockdown. But anyway, I'll speak to you tomorrow. Good morning. It's nice and sunny today, which is a stark contrast to yesterday, where it was essentially pitch black at like 4 p.m. But as you can see, I did decide to wash my hair today. Actually, straightened it for once. I don't really straighten my hair that much anymore. Long.
It's long, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's because you normally curl it, so it normally takes
length
out.
So Alfie and I just nipped into town quickly because we wanted to, well, I needed to nip into Boots to get some more of my, I know you're gonna ask if I don't show you, my favorite moisturizer, which is the Embryolisse La Creme Concentrate. I've run out to the point where I am squeezing so much out of the tube, the tube is like breaking because it's like that metal, kind of metal tube. One thing that I haven't actually spoken about in a vlog yet, and I didn't vlog last week, and that was when Alfie talked about it on his channel, is the fact that we have purchased a new office space, which is something that we did months ago, but it's being done up, and we've got like lots of little clips of like the day we got the keys and like going in, and it's really exciting. But I wanted to put it all into a video with like some, like, here's what it looks like now, here's a little bit of an update, and then
for renovation,
like, yeah, like showing more of the process of renovating it, which is something that neither of us did when we moved into our house, and that was purely for like security reasons, and just that we were unsure if people would be interested in that back then, I suppose.
It was so many, it was like 5 years ago when we were doing it. We're making very different content.
Yeah, we're making very different content now. What we're interested in is very different, and I think back then I just didn't think anyone would be that interested in seeing like us doing up our house. Turns out I feel like a lot of you probably would have been interested in that. And it's something that we now can't change. We can't go back and renovate our house again. But it was something that once we had bought this office space, we decided we were definitely gonna try and document the kind of the whole process of renovating it, because it is really, really exciting. As you know, we were in the space beforehand, which was an office that we both loved. No complaints there, it's just that it was a rented space, and we'd always had the intention that we would rent for a bit until something came up that we could buy and invest in and feel like we had a bit more of an input in that sense, I suppose. So we were in that office, the rented office space, which was a large outgoing, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it was something that was,
I mean, commercial space is very, yeah, expensive.
Commercial space is very
so
expensive.
Much more expensive than residential.
Yeah, and we were very aware of the outgoings of that office, and it, as much as we loved it, we did always have the intention of purchasing. So once this space came up, we decided to go for it, and now we are in a new office. How long do we think until it's going to be done? Another month?
So we've currently ordered, literally the other day Zoe and I sat down and did, like, we've been Pinterest boarding for months now, designing all the separate spaces and rooms. We've ordered everything other than two things. One is the floor upstairs, the three things, the lighting downstairs, the floor upstairs, and the semi-wall, semi-crittle style wall, the only things we haven't ordered. So we're waiting for those to all be delivered, and then they can be installed. But it's kind of, if you've done a renovation process, either a property like commercial or residential yourself, you'll know that the first fixtures, like the wiring and electronics and
they always seem
like that,
to take the longest. Yeah.
And it's the least visual.
It's the least gratifying.
Yeah. We're kind of at the point now where as soon as stuff starts arriving, it's going to quickly come together.
Yeah, that's where we were earlier. And I did film a little update, but as I said, I'm gonna put that in its own video because I've also got footage from the day we got the keys. So I'll be putting that into another vlog, which will probably go up next week, I should imagine. But it's really exciting. Sorry to tease. You can actually go over to Alfie's channel if you want to go and watch like a bit more of it. But can you still watch mine next week?
No, they can wait and watch yours as well.
Now we're just heading back. Alfie's got to do some editing. I'm going to give Joe a new skincare routine, which I'm really excited about. I'm going to get my dermatologist head on, which I don't have at all, but I'm going to try and tell him what he should and shouldn't be using. If you're confused about why Joe's at our house, he's currently bubbling with us. Is that the word, bubbling?
He's in our bubble.
He's in our bubble. Right before London went into lockdown, Joe came to stay and he just didn't go back.
He was like,
do I go back and just be on my own and not be able
back,
to...
He has to stay in London.
Yeah, as soon as he goes back to London, he has to stay in London. So he was like, well, I can work from here, so I'll do that. But it's been really nice having him there. It feels like being back at like I haven't really lived with Joe. since 2013. I'm really enjoying having him around though, it's really nice. And so we're going back to Joe, and then later on we're going to your mum and dad's for a roast dinner. We're leaving Joe at home because we didn't want to add an extra person to the six people. So we are being very strict with those rules, and we're not having more than six. So sadly, we're leaving Joe at our house while we go to Alfie's mum and dad's for a roast. But he doesn't mind, he's gonna make himself some dinner, he's all good.
Have you said about the clocks going back?
Oh my god.
It feels, I just looked at the time and it's 20 past two and I'm like,
it's my favorite day.
How is it not 6 p.m. yet?
It's my favorite day. So I said yesterday that this time of year always makes me feel so tired because of the darker evenings and the dark mornings. But last night the clocks went back, which meant we had a lighter morning, an extra hour in bed. So when I woke up at half six, it was actually half seven. So I felt like
half six.
Yeah, but it was light.
Yeah, but that's too early. On a Sunday, that's genuinely not good. That's too early.
Maybe I should have a nap when I get back. Anyway, I feel like this is the longest day in the world and I'm really enjoying how long this day feels. I'm feeling really revitalized and energetic, and I like how long this day feels. However, as Alfie pointed out, it will get to 6 p.m. and I will want to go to bed. That's where I'm gonna get jet lag.
No, it's not. It's not jet lag. The clock's changing isn't, Zoe's calling it jet lag. When the clocks change, you can't say you're jet lag.
Okay, season lag. This is going to be the weirdest vlog because I just feel like it's massive chunks of just me talking at you and not really showing you anything. But, you know, it's been a chatty vlog. I actually said to Alfie that I think I might start answering a question if I just randomly do little Q&As. Or actually, if you just leave some questions in videos, I want to start answering one question in every vlog I do. At some point in the vlog, I just want to answer a question. Picking a question in every vlog to answer and just having a couple of minutes to like sit and chat about something.
It's not very common, is it?
Well, this is the problem. You thought my vlogs were already long.
In this video, the next one's already up because this one's a 4-day vlog.
Literally, I just want to do that. So let me know if you think that's a good idea, and if you have questions that you'd love me to answer, preferably something that's not like a one-word answer because that would just be a bit pointless. Something that requires a bit more thought, a bit more depth, a bit more. Yeah, conversation. But leave them
maybe
below.
Maybe you could all answer the question as well.
Yes.
So you answer a question.
I'll answer it and then you can answer it.
And then everybody else can comment their answers to the same
love
question.
Love that idea, Alfie. So creative.
Back home and I am craving some cream of tomato soup. So I'm gonna go halves with Joe on a can of soup and a bagel because it's autumn and soup is, autumn is soup time.
This just looks too good. Maybe I should have done toast. I should have melted some cheese on the bagels. Maybe that would have been a bit much. Joe's watching Parasite, which I have to say is up there with one of my favorite films of 2020. I love it. You fell asleep though. You haven't.
I did fall asleep.
You haven't watched it in all its glory.
Well, I saw a bit with the dad. No, I missed a bit with the dad becoming a driver.
Oh yeah.
But I woke up just after that, and he then recommended his wife to be the housekeeper.
No. Don't give it all away in case anyone hasn't seen it.
Oh yeah. Spoiler.
Happy Monday! I didn't film much more yesterday because we obviously went to Amanda and Nick's in the evening, had a roast, came home. And as predicted, I was absolutely cream crackered, knackered. So I went to bed. I've also discovered I've got a sty. You can actually see it more in the camera than you can in real life. It's so painful in here. I'm not gonna touch it, but I felt it last night when I was taking my makeup off. I was rubbing my eye and I was like, oh, that hurts. So today is going to be a no makeup day because I don't want to be putting anything around it or on it. Amanda told me I needed to rub an old penny on it. I'm going to Google it. Not that I don't trust what she's saying, but I don't know if I should be rubbing coins in my eye during a global pandemic, but it was her penny and she's fine, so. Hello.
Hi.
Oh look, we're wearing the same outfit.
So the sunglasses. Oh my god, we actually are wearing the exact same clothes.
Same outfit.
What are we like?
We're basically repping Alfie right now. That's so funny.
Reminds me of the, remember the sunglasses days? You were
saying. Yeah. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, so two more things that I wanted to talk about in this vlog, which has largely just been me talking at you, is that this week is publication week for mine and Amy's book, The Magpie Society.
Yes!
Yes! I'm so excited. This is the final book. I don't know if I've shown it here on this channel, but this is the final book. This is what you will receive if you've pre-ordered. Thank you also to everybody who's done a pre-order. Pre-orders are like super important for authors. It really means a lot to Amy and I that you have pre-ordered and that you're excited. Sometimes they arrive earlier, in fact. I've seen some people who already have them. So if that's you, let me know what you think. And yeah, I'm really happy with it. This week is really weird. I always find like publication week of a book like really exciting, but also like really nerve-wracking and a little bit like, what's the word?
Well, you've been working on it for so long. And it all comes down
it just
to
feels
one
weird,
point.
Doesn't yeah. it? It feels weird that this is like done now and it's like ready for other people to read.
But also, it'd be weird this year for you because obviously because of COVID, we can't have a launch party.
Can't do a launch, can't do any events. We were planning on doing some book signings and some book events, which we now can't do. But speaking of events, we are able with Waterstones to do an online like Zoom event. So Amy and I will be going live on Zoom with Waterstones and my lovely friend Scarlett Curtis will be hosting it. So it's going to be like a Q&A, we're going to chat about the book, answer some questions. So if anybody would like to buy a ticket to that event, I will leave all the information down below. I think it will just be really nice because you can attend from the comfort of your own bed, learn a little bit more about me and Amy, the writing process, how it was for us to write during lockdown, how it was to co-author, which actually I really, really enjoyed. I won't like give too much away now, but yeah, it's basically a conversation with me and Amy, chatting all things Magpie, and that's on the 30th of October, so that is on Friday. Yeah, so that's Friday, that's the day after the book launches. Included in your ticket price will obviously be a book. If you've already purchased the book, you can redeem that. But I will leave all the information below. So if that sounds up your street, go and check it out. Come along, it'll be lovely to have you there. Waterstones are also hosting a competition where 10 people after the Zoom event can have a private Zoom Q&A session with me and Amy immediately afterwards. So also leave a link to that below if that sounds like it's up your street. But yeah, overall, it's an exciting week. I'm a bit nervous. If you haven't pre-ordered yet, there's still time to get it before it comes out. So I will leave a link below for that as well. We actually popped into a bookshop in Lewis that had done a really lovely review on Instagram of the book. They'd had one of the proof copies and we popped in and the lady was like, "Oh my God, I loved it. When's the next one?" And I was like, "Oh my God, oh yeah, I need to start on the next one." But it feels really wild to be thinking about starting the second one when this one's literally only just about to go out. But yeah, Magpie Society, One for Sorrow, Thursday. Look at this as well. I really love this inside, the purple. And then look, how cool is that? With the purple feather. Just love it. It's also crazy because like my friends and family are now finishing it because I gave them all proofs. How far in are you?
Chapter
13. Chapter 13. Joe's up to chapter 13. What chapter is that? I'm gonna have a look. Oh, Joe's read this much so far. and Amanda is reading it at the moment. Poppy's waiting for the audiobook, which also quite a few of you have asked me if it's coming out on audiobook. Yes, it is. So if listening to a book is more up your street, then that will be available on Thursday as well. Read by two amazing actresses. I'm so excited to listen to it myself. I've not heard it yet. We heard a snippet of both of their voices when it came to choosing who was going to read the book. And so we've heard kind of what they will sound like, but I haven't actually heard the whole thing yet. So I'm as excited as you are to hear that. And yeah, it's all happening. I need to get rid of this sty before Friday. Because I think I'll need to wear some makeup for that. So I'm not too sure how this has happened, but me and Joe are gonna go on a walk run. I say a walk run. Joe actually goes running. I was doing the couch to 5K for a while, as you know, but I have stopped doing it. So I feel like the best place for me to start is like week 4 or week 3 of couch to 5K and like build back up. But I do want to start getting back outside and like exercising a bit more, just because when I was doing it, I felt so good. And since Joe's been here, he's been on a run. And he was like, oh, I think I might go on another one. And I was like, oh, maybe I'll come with you. So when I call you in about half an hour saying, can you come and rescue me, Alf? Are you okay with that?
You're gonna call me like, I can't drive the car home, my legs ache. I'm gonna have to run to you
to get me
to drive you home.
But we're also bringing Nala, so unbeknownst to her, she's gonna get a little run as well. Okay, let's go. I'm on the old iPhone because I left my camera at home. A bit bulky to take on a run. Joe's basically run the whole way. Obviously Nala's having a good time. I didn't realize how unfit I was, though, I'm not gonna lie. It's crazy the difference couch to 5k makes, because it builds you up and you don't actually realize how much better you're getting at it until you stop and you try and go again without doing it, and it's very hard. We're not actually doing the couch to 5k, we're just running, and I'm just walking when I need to walk, but Joe's just running the whole thing. It's nice to get outside though. Lovely evening. Nala's actually doing better than me.
She's got 4 legs, which helps.
Oh yeah, true. I'd quite like 4 legs.
Stop vlogging as an excuse not to run. Keep running. You can vlog and run.
Okay. Cool. Oh, Nala, come on, I'm coming. Is this even running? Isn't this jogging?
Jogging, yeah, it's more jog.
Oh, that's a bit disheartening. Woo! Alfie's off to film a podcast. Secrets out.
See you later.
The secret's out.
Secret's out. The what?
That's the new theme tune. We've been working on it since I've been down here.
What is it?
When I came down, Alfie was like, oh, can you help me think of a new theme tune for the show?
Yeah.
You know, before it was like, did it? It's that little
thing. Yeah, the little jingle.
Yeah, he wants to change the jingle.
Oh, yeah, I will.
He wants to change the jingle, so he's got me to do the voice of it.
Oh.
So now it goes, secret's out when Alfie's about. Doobie-doobie-doobie, the secret's out. When Alfie's about.
There he is. There he's out.
Yeah.
So now the secret's out because Alfie's out.
Yeah, so get ready for that coming soon to Alfie's podcast.
What are you doing?
I'm drawing. I've been working on this.
I'll show them a sneak peek.
For bloody ages, right? I've been working really hard. Like, that's the thing. I've not uploaded YouTube videos in what feels like forever.
You're an artist now.
Because I've been obsessed with drawing. And realistically, it probably should end as a hobby, but I've created a character, basically, that I'm going to introduce to the world soon, and I want, and this character is going to go places. The plan is to have a create a character that's more popular than myself. It should be too hard to do.
How do you think I did on that run?
It was a good effort, actually. There was a bit where we were based on the home straight, and so we tried to give up, and I was like, are you serious? We're going to give up here? We basically finished the run.
And do you know what it is? When the end is in sight and it just feels so long away, that's the hardest bit.
Nah, because it's almost like that's the... When the end's in sight, it's not long away.
But
the end's in sight, it means you're really close to finishing. And you've got to really, like, work on that. Just, I think I think you're not as unfit as you think, but I think you've just got it in your head that, like...
I have a mental block.
Your mental is just like, ah, oh, that will do.
I'm going to end it here. Thank you so much for watching. Lots of things to check out in the description. Pre-order Magpie. Come along to the event on Friday. If you're having a night in on Friday and you just want something cosy to watch, you don't have to be on camera or anything. It's not like a Zoom where, like, everyone sees everyone. You can just come along and listen and watch. And it'll be really nice. Have a bit of book chat. And yeah, I'm gonna go now.
What's book chat? Is that like kombucha?
No, book chat. Chatting about books.
What are we on about then?
Book chat. And I will see you very soon. Also aware, I said I was going to unbox my autumn candles in this video, but I haven't. So that will come in the next video. Might have to open them with Joe, because usually I sit and do that with Mark, but obviously Mark can't be in the house. So I'll see if Joe wants to be my...
What, open candles?
Yeah, you know Bath and Body Works?
I don't know who that is.
Oh, well, that could be a fun video. Thanks for watching. Speak to you soon.